guys, it's God Bars here, the self-proclaimed hip-hop historian, and this is the 65th episode of my series where I grab a vinyl from my collection, talk about why I love it, what influence it had, and what its place is in the grand scheme of hip-hop. Going back over to the concrete jungle, today we're talking about Stove God Cooks, an insanely talented artist who criminally only has one album to his name, though I do believe a new project is coming around the corner. Regardless, the last few years, Stove God has been a standout feature on a myriad of Griselda albums, and I'm pretty sure he's officially been part of their roster for a while now. However, he wasn't when I first heard of him. That was actually back in 2019 on Roc Marciano's Marcialago album, where I believe he was just credited as Cooks, his rap name for some period of time before he added the Stove God. This put him on my general radar, but at the time I didn't think of this placement as much more than just an enjoyable feature on a quality album. The next time I heard about him was somewhere online, where I learned he was a protege of Busta Rhymes in the earlier days of his career, and I then saw Busta post about the Reasonable Drought album when it dropped. I went to give it a spin, and I remember it wasn't one of those projects that takes a few tries to click. I was enamored from front to back right away. I definitely enjoyed it more and more over time and appreciated new aspects about it with each listen, but it was already on constant repeat after the first playthrough. The singing may have not been my favorite part at first, but I remember that clicking as well when I watched Den and Hip Hop talk about the debut and someone made a comparison along the lines of a coke-dealing Drake. I haven't watched that review in a while, so I may be misquoting, but I'll link the original video down below since Den and Hip Hop is definitely my favorite hip-hop-related YouTube channel, and has been for well over a decade now. Either way, it's the similar type of infectious quality Westside Gunn's voice has. But while I absolutely love his voice, I feel like Stove God's is slightly less likely to get called annoying, which is something I see said about Westside sometimes online. He's actually a pretty talented vocalist, and even if he's off-key or not hitting a note 100% perfectly, he has more than enough personality and character to pull it off. He could really be rapping about anything, and he'd still stick out of a crowd due to the sheer charisma and clever wordplay he puts into every line. But the fact that a good chunk of the time he's singing about flipping birds or spraying someone up from the back of a car is really the cherry on top for me. Hearing traditional artists sing about directly shipping packs of cocaine is pretty novel, but on the other hand, so is hearing drug-dealing rappers sing about those acts. This makes Stove God sort of a pioneer in my eyes, because it isn't really just the concept of singing about drugs as much as how it's executed here. Not only is Stove God an insanely talented lyricist, I'd argue one of the most promising to come from this entire movement, but Roc Marciano fully produces this LP, and I think he's one of the modern legends who really brings their A-game pretty much any time they choose to fully produce an album for another rapper. Some of the other people I put in that group where they practically never fail when teaming up with an MC are The Alchemist, Apollo Brown, Real Bad Man, Kenny Siegel, LP, and of course Madlib, who, sort of like LP and The Alchemist, aren't as much modern producers as they are OG legends who've managed to keep their careers flourishing for decades. With Roc Marci, while I'm a sucker for the loops he uses and can't think of a beat I downright dislike from him in general, Reasonable Drought is the best set of instrumentals he's ever crafted, in my opinion. They're cold, cinematic, and somehow luxurious yet grimy at the same time. And in the past, I've heard the critique that Roc Marciano beats never have drums, or the drums are so low in the mix they might as well be non-existent. While that can definitely be true for certain instrumentals or even projects of his, that sound obviously had vast appeal and influence in its own right. I personally love that sound and the movement it's brought about, but if it isn't your cup of cocaine-filled tea, you're in luck, because for the most part, Roc Marci smartly took a step away from his recognizable, more minimal drum programming to give Stove God a fiery set of beats that fit his style more. There's still songs like Money Puddles or Crosses that utilize the lack of drums to put emphasis on Stove God, but a track like Rolls-Royce Brake Lights has so much energy that it was the perfect selection to start the album off with. The chops are just exquisite, and it's beats like that one I feel would have been massive hits if they were made in like 2004 for somebody like Cam or Jay-Z. Though of course I'm ultimately glad that wasn't the case, since these beats wouldn't be complete without Stove God Cook's ad-libs as well as his endless quotable one-liners. Since there's no guest producers or features on Reasonable Drought to speak of, I can take the time to share some of Stove God's most memorable bars, or at least the ones that really stuck with me. One of my favorite little sections comes on the intro track where he says, "You got collage work, his shit mixed with his shit, mixed with they work, my shit is Cinderella slipper, I ain't sorry for the wait, bitch I was in the kitchen dancing on the late. They wrote my story out in invisible ink. They like what took so long. I'm like, homie, I barely blinked. Even the lines right after that set are just nasty, with Snow God rapping, God bless a homicide, God bless the shooter, your soul's a computer, you Google rumors, I scale fish boy, I move units, I stepped on it twice and I meant to, the scale got chandelier crystals, the planets revolve, my people shoot pistols. Hopefully by now you're getting an idea of why I love this project so much and why I prop Snow God Cooks up as such a talented and promising artist. But if you need one more lyrical example, I'd go with the killer set of lines he has towards the middle of Crosses, where there's so much hunger and emotion behind his words it can give you chills. Here he spits, fentanyl flow, you bit off more than you could chew. My daughter wear chinchillas to the petting zoo. Got my bitch eating breakfast at Tiffany's. I knew the shit was meant for me when I was whipping keys. I understand Remy. I would have shot too, cause back then I couldn't risk a G. This shit risky business. I knew life was changing when them 15 chickens came. Bitch, my wrist amazing. Don't make me go throw on my bigger chain. In a tsunami, I sell a brick of rain. There's honestly an endless amount of dope one-liners here, but the last bar I have to share is Upstate Brick Breaker, still got one hand on the rock like cliffhangers. This album has such a tight track list, it sucks having to cut any out, but for my honorable mentions, they'd probably have to be Bread of Life, Jim Boheim, Money Puddles, Burton State, Lava Lamp, and John Starks. That being said, my three favorite tracks overall would have to be Rolls Royce Brake Lights, Crosses, and Break the Pyrex. Thank you for watching my 65th video. Next time we're going to talk about a legend who got his start in Chicago, but really made a name for himself in the LA underground scene. Tune in to see who that is, and if you enjoyed, be sure to like, subscribe, and let me know what your favorite moments off this exciting future star's debut were. Don't forget to have a great day, and I'll see you next time, okay? Alright.